Hello, sound check. Okay, class, good afternoon. So this afternoon, I will be discussing to you about the topic entitled protozoa. So first, balikan muna natin yung definition ng invertebrate. So invertebrates are basically organisms without backbone or lacking of backbone. They have invertebrates has its own classification, which is namely sponges, cnidarians, worms, mollusks, and echinoderms. So to proceed with, in the kingdom Protista, organisms that belong to the kingdom Protista or aka protist is divided into three major groups, which is number one is the animal-like protozoa, the second one is eukaryotic-like algae, and then the fungus-like slime. So the term protozoa comes from a Greek word meaning proto, first, and then zoa, animals. So bakit sila tinatawag na animal-like? Simply because of their behavior is animal-like. They move around in order to find prey or food. So one example is the paramecium. Paramecium has a cilia. So ano ang cilia? The cilia is a hair-like structures that helps in collecting food particles and then driven to the oral group. Ito pala yung cilia, yung nakapalibot na hair-like structure sa paramecium, and then this one is the oral group. So pag pumasok sa oral group, they are stored in the food vacuoles for the consumption of the paramecium. So protozoans are single-celled organisms. They have DNA enclosed in their nucleus. They have membrane-bag organelles in their cell, similar to humans and animal cells. So they exist only in one cell. That's why they are called single-celled organisms. So going back, pareho pala sila ng animal cell. They also have mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, nucleus, and then etc. So protozoans represent four major groups. So what are these? Let's see. So these are flagellates, ciliates, sarcodina, and then the parasitic sporozoans. So flagellates. Flagellates move with the help of flagella. Flagella is a thread-like structure attached to the cell. So one example of that is the free-living Chlamydomonas. So the flagellate of the Chlamydomonas are presented inside the box. Another one is the parasitic Trichomonas. So if we have organisms that have two flagella, we also have flagellate that only possesses one flagella. One example of this is the Euglena. Euglena has a single flagella. The another one is the colony-forming Cynura, also having a single flagella. So the next major group is the ciliates. So ciliates move around with the help of the cilia. This group of protists are provided with a numerous hair-like structure called cilia. So one example of that is the paramecium. So as mentioned earlier, ciliates have cilia. So sa paramecium, slippery shaped paramecium, ciliates are almost entirely present in the body of the paramecium. Compared with the verticella, concentrated lang siya sa isang part ng protozoa. So, ayan siya, as shown in the picture. So, the next one, or the last, ay not last, the third group, the third important group, are called sarcodina. Sarcodina has no definite shape. The cell membrane is so flexible that they change shape constantly. They move around with the help of pseudopods or pseudopodia. Pseudopodia is also known as false feet. So, pseudopods are formed only when they are needed. For example, the amoeba. So, ito po yung pseudopods ng amoeba. Ayan. But these pseudopods, when they are not needed, sometimes they just disappear. Another example of that is the radiolarian. The pseudopods of the radiolarian is also called, or also known as, the axopodia. The axopodia is much more complex compared to other pseudopods. So the last is the parasitic sporozoans. So sporozoans are all parasitic. They produce spores at a certain stage of their life. The spores are light and tiny and easily scattered by wind, water, and other agent. Madali sila mapasa from one host to another. So this blank circle as presented is the red blood cell. And this one is the called plasmodium. Plasmodium is a sporozoan that causes malaria. So hindi pala galing sa mosquito yung malaria, but yung mosquito is carrier lang ng mga spores ng sporozoans. Then pag kinagat na tayo, makakapasok siya sa ating red blood cells, and then yung spores papasok sa red blood cells, thus infecting us with malaria. So, why do protozoa are important? So, let's see. So, protozoans are important and play a major role in food chain. Some of them are mutualists and pathogens. So, what are pathogens? Pathogens are microorganisms that can cause diseases. Example of the pathogen is in our water. Our water can taste awful when there's an enormous amount of cyanura uvela present in our potable water. It exhibits foul odor na hindi kayang itolerate ng human para mainom or drink. So another example is the entamoeba histolica, one that lives in the intestine of man through contamination of food or water. It can produce ulcers in the walls of the intestines and causes abdominal pain, diarrhea, or even bloody diarrhea. A small number of protozoans are very harmful to hosts, and some just live as parasite. So, what is the importance of it in the biosphere? It plays a role in the biosphere in terms of mineralizing nutrients, thus making available for plants and other soil organisms. The recycled nutrients are then used by plants and other organisms in the nutrient cycle. So that's all, and then thank you.